Welcome to an example on how to find the inverse of a 3x3 matrix using an augmented matrix. The first step is to create an augmented matrix in the form where the left side is matrix A, or the given matrix, and the right side is an identity matrix. Then we perform row operations resulting in an augmented matrix in the form where the left side becomes the identity matrix and the right side will be the inverse of matrix A. So the main idea is to set up the augmented matrix where matrix A is on the left side of the matrix, perform row operations to form the identity matrix from matrix A, and the right side will be A inverse, or the inverse of the original matrix. So because we're given a 3x3 matrix, we'll have the given matrix on the left, and on the right side we'll have a 3x3 identity matrix. So we'll have a 3x6 augmented matrix, where the first three columns will come from matrix A, and the fourth, fifth, and sixth columns will come from a 3x3 identity matrix. So we would have 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, and 0, 0, 1. A lot of times you'll see the augmented matrix divided in half. Now we'll perform row operations, so the augmented matrix has a 3x3 identity matrix on the left, or looks just like this matrix here. In this form, the three columns on the left would be the inverse of matrix A. So we'll start by obtaining zeros in the correct positions, and then make sure this diagonal here consists only of ones. Let's start by obtaining a zero in this position here. Notice the element above it is -2, so if this was +4, we could then add row 2 and 3 to obtain a 0. So let's replace row 3 with -2 times row 2 plus row 3. Let's also obtain a 0 in this position here using row 1 and row 2. The least common multiple of 2 and 3 is 6. So if we multiply row 1 by 2, then add it to 3 times row 2, we would have a 0 here. So 2 times row 1 plus 3 times row 2. And then while we're here, let's go ahead and obtain a 0 in this position here. Notice the element below it is +1. So let's go ahead and replace row 1 with row 1 plus row 2. Notice we're performing three different row operations all in one step. So starting in the first row, we'll add row 1 and row 2. So 3 plus -2 is 1. 3 plus -2 is 1 again. -1 plus 1 is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 1 is 1. And 0 plus 0 is 0. We need to be extra careful on the second row operation. We have 2 times row 1 plus 3 times row 2. So 2 times 3 is 6, plus 3 times -2, that's -6, so that's 0. 2 times 3 is 6, plus 3 times -2 is -6, that's also 0. Next we have 2 times -1, that's -2, plus 3 times 1, that's +3, so that's +1. Next we have 2 times 1, that's 2, plus 3 times 0, that's still 2. 2 times 0 is 0, plus 3 times 1 is 3, so that's 3. 2 times 0 is 0, plus 3 times 0 is still 0. For row 3, we have -2 times row 2 plus row 3. So -2 times -2 is +4, plus -4, that's 0. -2 times -2 is +4, plus -5, that's -1. -2 times 1, that's -2, plus 2, that's 0. And then we have -2 times 0, that's 0, plus 0, still 0. -2 times 1, that's -2, plus 0, it's -2. And -2 times 0 plus 1 is 1. So we made a lot of good progress so far. Notice we can obtain a 0 in this position here if we replace row 1 with row 1 plus row 3. Let's go ahead and do that. But notice how row 2 has a 0 in column 1 and column 2, which would be better if it was in row 3. So let's go ahead and interchange row 2 and row 3. So for row 1 we have 1 plus 0, that's 1. 1 plus negative 1, that's 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus negative 2 is negative 1. And finally, 0 plus 1 is 1. And then we're going to interchange row 2 and row 3. So we have 0, negative 1, 0, 0, negative 2, 1. And 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 0. Notice how we're almost there now. This first element in row 2 has to be positive 1. So for our last step, we're going to replace row 2 with negative 1 times row 2. Row 1 and row 3 stay the same. And then multiplying by negative 1 is going to change the sign of all the elements in row 2. So we'll have 0, 1, 0, 0, positive 2, negative 1. Now notice this augmented matrix is in the form that we need, where the left side of the augmented matrix is a 3x3 identity matrix, which means the right side is A inverse, or the inverse of the original 3x3 matrix. So A inverse is equal to a 3x3 matrix, where row 1 is 1, negative 1, 1, row 2 is 0, 2, negative 1, and row 3 is 2, 3, 0. Which means that A times A inverse is equal to A inverse times A, which would be equal to a 3x3 identity matrix. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful. We'll take a look at another example in the next video.